Music is intangible. It's made of this very subtle, very delicate material, right? Just sound waves. I can't see the music. Sometimes I might feel the vibrations if with a very loud thumping bass, for example, but I can't touch them. I can't hold them. They seem to disappear as soon as the musician stops playing or singing. At the same time, this very ephemeral, intangible art is tied up with a lot of solid things. Pianos, iPhones, turntables, drums, and so on. And these technologies are made for human bodies. Headphones are made for ears, piano keys for fingers, and so on. So my dissertation, which turned into my first book, takes these technical objects seriously. It asks how musical instruments might shape performers' experience and how these instruments might affect music's sounding organization. So if you press a key with your hand, you hear a sound. So both auditory and motor parts of your brain are engaged. And if you practice an instrument over and over throughout a lifetime, you develop a very strong connection between these auditory and motor areas, what I like to call a link between the ear and the hand. At that point, a pianist, if they hear piano music, the motor parts of their brain are primed, are kind of active, even if they're not really moving their hands. And if they make piano playing movements, like on a table or on their arm, the auditory parts of their brain are active, even though they're not actually hearing the sound. It's a two-way connection that opens up new kinds of experience so that musicians can feel the sound and hear the movement. My work draws on psychological and phenomenological perspectives on this kind of body technology interaction. But it also analyzes instrumental patterns. So in this piece on the slide, this composition is actually based around the pattern of the piano's black notes, the raised keys. And that's a physical pattern as much as a sounding one. But the physicality of it and the logic of the pattern is often only sensible, only perceptible for the performer. And it's something that a listener who doesn't play the piano might not be able to notice. So the basic idea then is that instruments actually make music manipulable so that it's actually not so intangible after all. Thank you.